don't look now, but the Dallas Cowboys are doing attractive things. There was an elephant in the room by way of a looming extension on DeMarcus Lawrence, but while they worked to figure that out, they were not sitting idly by. They waved off the first week of NFL free agency and stuck to their predictably frugal guns, but did an about-face in the second wave, and not financially. They were able to keep their purse strings taut while landing several key free agents, including wide receiver Randal and safety George Aloka, among others. Before the dust could settle on either of those signings, they finalized the parameters on a deal that landed defensive end Robert Quinn via trade with the Miami Dolphins. Only days following the conclusion of that deal, Lawrence was awarded his massive payday, setting the stage for what could be a dominant pass rush this coming season. Others will need to step up in a big way, but it's clear that when looking across the depth chart at the Cowboys' defensive line, there will be many a nightmare had by quarterbacks and opposing offensive coordinators alike in 2019. It is done. The recent news and contract talks between Lawrence and the Cowboys saw the club upping their initial offer of $17 million annually to $20 million per year, but Lawrence reportedly wanted around $23 million per season. That left the two sides at an impasse, as explained by team exec Stephen Jones, but it was Jones who called Lawrence after 2 weeks of silence to get the deal done. In the end, it's a five-year, $105 million contract with $65 million in guarantees and a historic $31.5 million first-year payout. The latter is the highest of any non-QB in NFL history, and is all the motivation Lawrence needs to immediately undergo shoulder surgery to be ready in time for the 2019 season. His 25 combined sacks over the last two seasons prove he can replicate success, and he's been available for two complete seasons following 2016, despite having a torn labrum in 2018. Lawrence's leadership will be key going forward as it has been in the past, and the Cowboys are thrilled to have locked down the best pass rusher the franchise has had since future Hall of Fame linebacker DeMarcus Ware. Quinn being brought in is quite the impactful compliment to Lawrence, by the way. Batman finally has his Robin. This is another stellar offseason move by the Cowboys. A former first-round pick 14th overall of the Los Angeles Rams, Quinn played 7 seasons with the organization before heading to the Dolphins in March 2018 via trade. It was a cap move for the Rams at the time, with Quinn being on the back end of a 6-year deal signed in 2014. He's had his bumps and bruises over the course of his time in the NFL, but has been mostly durable, having been available for fewer than 15 games only twice in his 8-year career. For a more recent scope on his availability, it's key to note he's played in 31 of the Dolphins' last 32 games, a stellar statistic for one of the most bruising positions in the game. He does most of his damage on the right edge, making it paramount the Cowboys figured things out with Lawrence to secure the left side of the line. It's now or never for Charlton. The former first-round pick was locked in heading into Cowboys training camp in 2018, shadowing Lawrence at every conditioning turn with the goal of making huge strides in his second year as an NFL pass rusher. The club loved what they saw, and rewarded him with 106 defensive snaps in the first two games, wherein he delivered 6 combined tackles, 2 for a loss, a pass breakup and a sack on quarterback Eli Manning in Week 2. In that same contest, he'd recover a fumble in the third quarter that the Cowboys used to make it a 2-touchdown deficit, going on to win and balance themselves at 1-1 on the young season. His stock jumped head first off of a cliff not long after. As the season progressed, however, Charlton seemed to regress, with part of the reason being an injured shoulder. He'd go on to miss several games because of it, landed on the inactives list following his return with reported attitude issues, before again seeing the game day roster. He's now had surgery to repair his shoulder, but with Quinn in the mix, he'll need to repair his value with the team as well. And quickly, the club can exercise his fifth-year option in 2020, but they need to have a reason too. Armstrong is still doing his homework. the University of Kansas taught the 6'4", 256 pounds, defensive end everything they could regarding academics, but they didn't do him any favors on the gridiron. His 2017 season saw him move to an outside linebacker in the team's 3-4 scheme, and his production, as well as his NFL draft stock, suffered as a result. The Cowboys weren't fooled though, fully confident in what Armstrong could be at the professional level when dropped back down to rush off the edge. Their confidence had them prepared to give up two picks for the benefit of moving up to select him, but thanks to a fortuitous turn of events, they didn't need to. Still available when the team went on the clock for their 116th overall selection, the team had their man and defensive coordinator Rod Marinelli could not have been more thrilled. With the draft firmly in the rear view, Marinelli dropped his rare smile and reverted right back to his whistle and usually bristled demeanor, approaching Armstrong with a handshake and an assignment to study former NFL pass rusher Chris Dolman, a Hall of Famer with 150.5 sacks on his resume. Armstrong is making strides to get on the field, but has more studying to do. If he catches his stride in training camp this year, however, he'll be the reason at least one of the players on this depth chart gets cut. Crawford is hoping the NFL doesn't hand down a suspension. He was detained following a bar fight at the Coyote Ugly Saloon in Panama City, Florida on Friday, March 15, after a melee broke out that had Crawford in the middle of it, much to the chagrin of security that tried to invade his personal space time and again. There were multiple injuries reported, included a broken foot on one bar staffer. Police arrived and restrained Crawford, but no arrests were made. The league office is investigating the event, and while all the facts have not been released, including what provoked Crawford in the first place, there's a chance he sees no punishment at all. If he does, however, as a first offender, it could result in a 1 or 2 game suspension, but having Quinn in the mix helps such a short-term issue. Crawford had 5.5 sacks in 2018, and was easily one of the best defensive linemen on the team. Woods burst onto the scene in 2018, and his fiery demeanor helped propel him from camp body to starting one tech. At one point during their 30-22 loss to the Los Angeles Rams, however, Woods went down with an apparent injury. He'd return to the game and finish the contest, considering what was on the line, but he wasn't his usual self, the interior bully the team has come to appreciate and need in the run game. The Rams would go on to a record-setting day on the ground against the Cowboys, ending their season, and it's since been revealed Woods played through a torn labrum. He's since undergone surgery and will be ready for camp this summer, making for a terrorizing defensive front, assuming the extension on Lawrence lands. The 2019 season will be a pivotal one for Collins. The former third-round pick has battled several injuries since being selected by the Cowboys in 2016, but battled through and subsequently did not miss a single game in his first two seasons, delivering 7.5 sacks that included 5 in his rookie season along with a forced fumble and a fumble recovery, despite having suffered a broken foot in OTAs that year. It was testament to both Collins' grit and resilience, both again being on display when he was available for the 2018 season opener against the Carolina Panthers after undergoing surgery to repair a broken foot 6 months prior. It's now 2019 and Collins isn't waiting to get his body ready for what happens to be the final year of his rookie contract, already putting in work far ahead of the Cowboys off-season program. He's hoping for a career season this fall after delivering 3 sacks last season, and if he can remain healthy, he'll have a real shot at hitting the next level. With David Irving no longer in the picture, it'll be Christian Covington placed in Collins' path for the role of starting 3 tech, so let the battle begin. Will this one of more underrated but intriguing signings for the Cowboys? The 26-year-old lands in North Texas by way of the Houston Texans, where he played after being dual-drafted, in the 6th round of the NFL draft and in the 5th round of the CFL draft the same year, 2015. It's not difficult to surmise why both leagues wanted him, considering the 6'3", 300 lb. interior specialist was named All-Conference USA as a sophomore at Rice University, and drew comparisons to Pro Bowl talents Michael Bennett and Lorenzo Alexander in pre-draft workouts. Covington, not to be confused with linebacker Chris Covington, who is also on the Cowboys roster, is a big body that can stop the run with ease but also disrupt in the opposing backfield. This makes him an ideal fit in Dallas, particularly now that they've moved on from Irving, and he's ready to push Malik Collins to the limit. He'll have just 1 year to do it though, and the Cowboys are waiting to see if he can woo them into a re-up in 2020. Hyder is a three-year veteran who found his way to the NFL by way of the New York Jets, who grabbed him out of the undrafted free agent pool in 2014. He'd go on to be released in August of that year, failing to survive final roster cutdowns, but landed on the Jets' practice squad. Eventually he'd dig his heels in for the Detroit Lions, spending four seasons there before satisfying his final contract in 2018. The 27-year-old was a rotational talent in Detroit in his 24 games there, but his 2016 season showed some very real promise, when he broke out to the tune of 8 sacks in only 2. Starts with 16 games played, Hyder would find that potential temporarily derailed the following season, when he suffered a torn Achilles and landed on injured reserve, ending his season, registering just one sack that year. A local product of Texas Tech, the Austin, Texas native is thankful to get another shot in the NFL, and especially in his home state, also on just a one-year deal. It's low risk for the Cowboys, with the potential for a very high reward. The addition of Quinn is especially important to Hyder, who will battle the former Dolphin, along with Charlton and Crawford, for snaps on the right edge. Ross initially signed with the Cowboys in 2017 on a two-year, $1 million contract. He has just 19 combined tackles in 16 games but 5 have been for a loss, and he has 9 hits on the opposing quarterback with 2 sacks. Those are more than solid numbers considering his minimal snap count, and being an exclusive rights free agent in 2019 gave the Cowboys sole discretion to either exercise his option or to let him walk outright, because he wouldn't have had the right to negotiate with other teams unless the latter occurred. They had until March 12th to make their final decision, and chose to keep him on for both depth and his ability to stop the run. Ross may not be a starter, but he's impacted a game or two in his time with the Cowboys. And made an active to reinsert Charlton into the lineup, the opposing rushing attack saw an uptick in production, and that's a nod to what Ross brings to the table. This is the kind of supporting cast that helps put a defensive line over the top. This is a definite insurance move for the Cowboys. Sheeta is a former undrafted free agent of the rival Philadelphia Eagles, so he lands in Dallas with some insight on the enemy's inner workings. From a football standpoint, he's not been able to achieve much due to a knee injury that saw him land on their injured reserve for the 2017 season, his second in the league. His rookie year was spent on the Eagles' practice squad, but his upside was well noted before injury. Sheeta delivered 5 tackles and a sack during the 2018 preseason, in limited duty, and August 2016 saw him land 6 tackles and 1.5 sacks, leading all Eagles defensive tackles at the time. After landing on the Cowboys practice squad on 2 separate occasions for 2018, he now has a contract to hang around a bit longer, but you'd be hard-pressed to see him making the 53-man roster in 2019. He's insurance, yes, but more of the 10-man variety and not the 53-man one.